The font that is used for title and text, the color schemes you choose, and background all form the style of a document. Word provides you with predefined styles to choose from, or you can create your own. Let's take a look at how styles work. Select the text you'd like to format. I'll just select my title. On the Home tab in the Style group, you can see four different styles. As you hover over each, you can see the selected text in your document change. To see more than these four, click the More drop-down arrow. As you move over each, you can see the style displayed in your document. Now, this style is named Heading 1, but I can use it for my title if I wish. As I look a little closer, I actually think this style called Title will look good. Just left-click it to select it. It now appears in the document. Let's go ahead and apply styles to the rest of the document. The executive summary is a main heading, so let me apply Heading 1. That looks pretty good. Sales team structure and process is another main heading, so I'll give it a Heading 1 style also. The chain of command and process are subheadings, so let's apply a Heading 2 style. I'm going to go through the rest of my document and apply the appropriate styles to my main and subheadings. It looks a lot better than when I started, but none of the predefined word styles are quite what I want for this document. But that's all right, because Word gives me the ability to modify the styles. Let's start by modifying the title style. Just select the text and the style you want to change. In the Styles group, locate the style. I'm looking for the title style. Right-click the style and the menu appears. Left-click Modify and the Modify Style dialog box appears. We can see that the name of the style is Title, and under Formatting, we can see all the details about the font. We can see the style, size, color, and alignment. We also have all the tools to make changes to the style. Let's see, I'd like for the year 2008 to appear on the line above it, so let's decrease our font size and let's see what happens. In the preview window, I can see that it's going to work. Just click OK to apply those changes to the document. Let's also modify the Heading 1 style, which I'm using for my main headings. I just need to select Executive Summary in my document and then locate Heading 1 in the Style group. And I'll just modify the font style this time. I think I'll change it to this font. Yeah, I've always liked the way it looks. There, that looks pretty good. You can see that it changed all my main headings. So far, I really like the predefined styles that Word gives me and the ability to modify those styles. But what if I want to create a new style that I specifically use for, let's say, our weekly memo? To do this, click the arrow in the bottom right corner of the Styles group. This opens the Styles task pane. Just click the New Style button at the bottom and a dialog box appears. From here, you can name your style and make all the decisions about how you want the style formatted. Let's see. I may want to call this Weekly Memo Title. And since it is a title, I'll make the font pretty big, and I like Arial as a font, and I think it will look nice centered. Once you've made your formatting decisions, just select the button beside New Document based on this template so that it will be available to use in all your documents, and then click OK. And now you can see that our weekly memo title style shows up in the list. To use it, you will apply it just like all the other styles. Another option you have is to use a style set. There are some predefined style sets that include a combination of title, heading, and paragraph styles. So instead of formatting your title and headings separately, you make one decision that applies to the entire document. To access these, click the Change Styles command on the ribbon, and then select Style Set from the menu that appears. As you hover over the style sets, your document will change as Word displays a live preview of how the style will affect your document. Although I like the way my report looks, let's try one of the style sets. Here. I think I like this one. Just left-click a style set to select it. You can also change the colors and the fonts of the style set from here as well, but the easier way to do this is to apply a theme to the document. If you've ever spent time trying to find the perfect fonts that look good together or choosing coordinating colors, then you will love using themes in Word 2007. Let's go ahead and take a look at the themes that come with your version of Word. Select the Page Layout tab and then click the Themes command. A document theme is a set of formatting choices that include font styles, sizes, and colors for different parts of the document and a set of theme effects such as lines and fill effects. You can see how the themes change the document and really give it a professional touch. There are 20 different themes that are included with the software. Once you find one that you like, just left-click a theme to select it, and the changes will be applied to the document. If you don't see a theme you like, you can always create a custom theme or access even more on Microsoft Office Online, right from this menu. To create a custom theme, just click the Themes command on the Page Layout tab. Once you've selected a theme, click the Colors command in the Themes group. Then select Create New Theme Colors. A dialog box appears. Use the drop-down menus to change the colors for each part of the document. I think I will stick with colors that will complement my logo. It's now time to enter a name for the theme color. Let's name it AdWorks Color. Click Save to keep the changes. We can also choose a font that goes along with our theme. Let's click the Fonts command. Select Create New Theme Fonts. A dialog box appears. Use the drop-down menus to change the fonts. To the right, I can see how my selections will look together before making a final decision. Now, just because I like two fonts doesn't mean they will look good together. There, these two fonts look pretty good together. Enter a name for your theme font. I'm going to enter AdWorks Font, and then click Save. Effects often add that extra little accent to your graphics. It could be as simple as a shadow or an embossed look. To add a theme effect, click the Effects command and select an option from the drop-down menu. Hover over several effects to see what they will look like in your document. When you find one that fits your theme, select it by left-clicking. I really like Apex. I want to make sure all of my choices are saved for this particular theme, so I need to click the Themes command and select Save Current Theme. A dialog box appears. Enter a theme name and click Save. Now the theme is available to use with other documents. If I don't like the color or the effects in my new theme, I can always go back and make changes later. One thing that is important to know is that themes and styles are connected. You absolutely cannot apply a theme to a document without applying styles first. Themes look for and replace the formats of each of the styles. So, if you take the time to apply a style to your titles, headings, subheadings, and body text, then you can take advantage of these really professional-looking themes. Spend some time practicing with styles and themes. If you use Word at work, you'll find that these are both valuable features that allow you to create a variety of documents that have a consistent professional design.